in light of today's first reading about Elijah, the wind and the rock, thought an appropriate opening song would have been, "And the mountains will fall and the hills turn to dust." Because we know the end of the world is coming, right? The end of the world is coming. Just look at all of the disasters that are happening all around the world. Powerful earthquakes that we've never seen before. Tsunamis that lay waste to entire islands. Hurricanes that inundate cities around our nation. Erupting volcanoes that spew lava and ash hundreds of feet in the air. Murder, violence, mass shootings everywhere you turn. Wildfires that destroy thousands and thousands of acres of forest. Climate change that is heating up our planet and will melt the polar caps, and the oceans will flood the cities along the coast. A hole in the ozone layer that will let the intensity of the sun's rays in to fry us into human crisp. Elijah had it easy. God is punishing us for all of our sinfulness. Repent and save yourself. Oh no, where do we go to escape God's wrath? I know, let's go live on Mars. We're inundated, daily with terrible news stories of natural disasters and some man-made tragedies. That is one of the consequences of our instant worldwide communications. And the human mind is drawn to the spectacular, the morbid and gruesome, the tragic. I don't know why that is. Maybe we get some comfort that it is, that it's not us in those situations, because if we were, we wouldn't even be able to see it in the news. We'd be trying to survive it, whatever the catastrophe. So we shake our heads and say, those poor people, let's pray for them. Then we go about our day to face our own insurmountable problems, like, what am I going to wear for that party on Sunday? Or, I don't know how I'm going to get everything done today that I have to do. Where was God in all of this? There's too much noise surrounding me to think that I could hear anything, much less God in a tiny whispering sound. Can't we turn down the volume at least a little bit? Yes, we can. If we are willing to separate ourselves from this world for a little while. Jesus tells us that when we want to pray, go to our room, close the door, and pray to our Father in secret. So we find that room in our home. Or we find that quiet, secret place of ours. And we tune the world out, so that we can hear the tiny whispering sound of God. And we need to hear the voice of God in order to know what to do and to get the strength to go out and do it. What do we need this day? It will be found in the silence. Not necessarily in words that we can articulate, but in a sense of mission. In a sense of conviction, in a sense of confidence in knowing that God is with me. Sure, the world is coming to an end. Jesus said that it would, but even he didn't know when it would take place. Natural disasters will continue to happen. That's the nature of the physical world we live in. One time is not any worse than another. And through it all, God remains faithful to us if we will but take the time and the space to be faithful to him. He is trying to communicate with